Welcome to Texas High School Football here in Davenport, Texas, here at Davenport Stadium. It's the Wolves versus the Bulldogs. The visiting Burnett Bulldogs will kick it away to the Davenport Wolves. 6-2 on the season, 3-0 in 4A Region 4 District 13 play. Bulldogs 5-2, 2-1. Sending the opening kickoff away is Sam Rodriguez. And we are playing football here in San Antonio, Texas. Good return down the right sideline. And it'll be good field position for the Wolves, a team that likes to score offense. Sam Kamen alongside my color analyst, Brad Lynn. Brad, this is an offense that puts up points, and they put them up in a hurry.
Well, the last four, 5 weeks, they've just lit the scoreboard up. It's just crazy how they've been able to put it together, and it's right about the right time for this time of year because they're doing a great job putting, like you said, often and quickly.
Tristan Hamlin, the lefty quarterback, will play a RPO, throws it out to Emmett Griman. He's got a first down and more, makes the guy miss, a sidestep inside the 30, inside the 25. Big pickup for the senior here on senior night.
Nice block by the wide receiver out there to get that screen going.
Two backs in the backfield with Hamlin. He's going to fake the give, throws it to Griman once again. Two pitches and catches for Emmett Griman, a guy that has 40 receptions on the year, averaging just under 100 yards per game, seven touchdowns on the season, one of three Wolves that have been selected to the San Antonio Sports All-Star Game here at the end of the season. Second and short, a give to Barrett Falcone. He's got the right side, and he's got the end zone. Touchdown, Davenport, and they only take 41 seconds off the scoreboard.
41 seconds and three plays in the end zone. That's got to be a tough pill to swallow early for Burnett, because you're hoping you can get something going on defense to slow these guys down, and they don't have an answer yet.
And it's interesting because this is a team that you score points early. Don't know if they actually won the toss to kind of accept the ball early, but they get to throw the first punch as the extra point by Miles Mendez is good. So just getting started here from Davenport. Sam Kamen alongside Brad Lynn. Brad, this is a big time game. Senior night here at Davenport. It's a 2-1 Burnett team versus a 3-0 Davenport team here in District 13. Again, this is a program that has just gotten started here for Davenport. It's only their fourth year open as a school, second year here in the UIL. They went 10-2 last year, 4-1 in district play, only losing to Canyon Lake as they finished second. And they've got a chance to win at least a share and for sure the number one seed here in District 13 if they win tonight.
Yeah, they've got a great playoff run ahead of them, but you know, when you said it was senior night, those kids have got to feel special to be the first seniors ever to graduate from the school and play football at a senior night game. Pretty cool.
26 seniors on the football team, lots more in the band as well as the color guard and dance team. Foot to leather there by Miles Mendez. They're going to fake a reverse. They're actually going to give it. And there's wide open down the far sideline. Can he make one guy miss? He's going to be dragged down. And it's their playmaker for Burnett. It's Grant Jones. A huge return for the Burnett Bulldogs.
Well, they have to have something like that to ignite them, because they want to go slow on offense. Get a touchdown, but go slow to keep Davenport off the offensive end.
They have a very balanced attack, averaging 31 points per game, 196 yards through the air, 194 on the ground. They're going to have to, like you said, play keep away. The longer they can keep this Davenport offense off the field, the better chances they have. A first down give to number one, Dash Denton. He's averaging 90 yards per game on the ground. Picks up a couple on first down.
It seems to be the mode for both teams is no huddle. Of course, Burnett would have to really speed up to go as fast as Davenport, but they're not slow themselves.
Huddles are a thing of the past.
No doubt.
Especially in this spread offense age. Dash Denton's going to be in the backfield with Rhett Murray, a quarterback for the Bulldogs. Trips left. He's going to throw a slant, and that one's just a bit high. Was looking for Colt Sanford as he got popped across the middle. So it's going to be third down. They're at the 40-yard line. Have to get to the 33. Third and seven. And analytics say this is probably four down territory.
Should be. Should be. With what they've got to accomplish is slowing them down. Free play.
Going to take a shot down the far sideline, and that one is dropped. Was looking for number four, Garner Krause.
It's not spectacular, but that's a good call by the Burnett coaching staff to draw them off sides because, you know, early in the game, they're going to be super excited to try to make a big play on third down. So they'll have a much better chance of converting this third down.
That's great awareness as well by Rhett Murray of noticing, hey, we got the jump. Let's take a shot because Krause was right there inside the 10 if he's able to make the overshot.
I think he got both hands on it. It would have been a spectacular play.
So now it's third and two on the offsides penalty. Got a tight end to the right. Denton to the left. They're going to give it to Denton, and it's going to depend on the spot. Looks like the far judge is going to say he's a little bit short. Fourth down. Like you said,
four down territory, though. They need to try to. I mean, what's the point of punting? Too long for a field goal? You got to do it.
Fourth. And a long one for Burnett. Davenport crowd trying to pump them up. Trying to create a huge fourth down stop for the defense. Denton to Murray's left. Trying to get a jump offside. They don't. And it's going to be a false start or a timeout.
Timeout. Nope.
They're going to say they got an early jump there. A flinch up front by the Burnett Bulldogs. So after getting five free yards on a free play, they give it right back, and now it's going to be fourth and six from the 39. Two receivers to the wide side of the field. Fake give. They're going to throw it to that side. Grant Jones, and good pursuit.
Great defensive play. Great defensive play by the whole unit out there. There was 11 kids running to the ball while it was in the air to that screen.
Ryan Howe with the stop and a big fourth down stop by the Davenport defense. They'll turn it over to their offense with, again, great field position at the 39-yard line. So they went three plays, took 34 seconds, went 52 yards on their first drive. Rolling to his left is Hamlin. Looking for a man, tight coverage on the far sideline, looking for number 13, Dante Singletary.
That's the only way you can slow them down is to play great defense. If you give them first downs, they're not going to slow down. They're a little slower now on a second and 10.
The more success they have, the faster they go.
Amen.
Hamlin barking out orders to his offensive line. Griman and Fallon in the backfield. And he's going to give it to Griman. Makes a guy miss in the backfield, only able to get a couple there. So it'll be third and long. They were 5 for 10 on third down conversions last week. And you can assume if they get a first down here, they're going to go
with that
up-tempo offense. Bunched up coverage, twins to either side. Fallon out of the backfield, running a wheel route. Coming through the pocket is Hamlin. Going to the far sideline, looking for a man, and that one was just thrown away. Great coverage on the back end by the Bulldogs, and it'll force a punt for Davenport.
Nice answer by the Burnett Bulldogs defense. Got to be embarrassed, got to be a little shell-shocked on three straight plays and touchdown on the first series, but they answered now with a well-done series.
So Trenton Park is back to receive for the Bulldogs. Miles Mendez, the kicker and the punter. Averaging 43 yards a punt. High snap, able to get it off. It will bounce, takes a Davenport roll, and hits a Wolf at the 30-yard line. So that's where the Burnett Bulldogs will start. 8:30 left here from Davenport Stadium. 7-0 lead for the Wolves. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
Park, we believe that shopping for a car.
First and 10 from the 30-yard line for the Bulldogs. Jet sweep going to the right. They give it to Grant Jones. Good sizable pickup on first down last week. Six receptions, 179 yards, and a touchdown in a big-time win versus Canyon Lake. Bulldogs won against the Hawks in their home territory, 45-25, trying to pull off another road victory. It would be the biggest one of their season.
No doubt. Slowing this offense down would be monumental.
Fakes the give, sets up the screen, able to get the tunnel screen to perfection, and just down right before midfield is Gardner Krause.
It's really nice blocking on that tunnel screen. Those aren't easy blocks because in an open field. Nice job.
Braden McKenzie and Johnny Karin on that right side of the offensive line, getting outside and setting up a good block for Krause, who also had six receptions, 131 yards, and two touchdowns versus the Hawks just last Friday. So Murray swings it out right.
Nice
play. And
oh,
able to break a tackle.
Get back to the line of scrimmage.
Was going to be a loss of yardage there, but good effort there by Dash Dent getting up to midfield. So second and 9 from midfield. Stopped on fourth down, their first possession. Bulldogs looking for an answer here. Murray looks back to the sideline, has trips to his left on the wide side. Denton to his right. Low snap, able to field it, and a 5-yard hitch route.
Great recovery by the quarterback on that bad snap, or low snap.
Colt Sanford with the reception. Marked just outside the 45, so again, third and medium for this Burnett Bulldogs offense.
Right now, Davenport seems to be content with a three-man rush and letting everybody else play coverage.
Trips to the wide side once again. No jump there for Davenport. An audible there for the Bulldogs. Murray, quick throw. That one's batted up in the air. A big-time PBU by number 0, Gianni Evans-Williams.
Just when I said they're content with the three-man rush, they brought the fourth one. They didn't see him. They couldn't account for him because he came from a long way away. Nice play.
Evans-Williams playing that will linebacker position. Came off the edge, untouched, and if you're not going to get to the quarterback, you want to get your hands up, and he did just that.
Nice jump.
So Rhett Murray actually comes out of the game. It's going to be the backup quarterback, Marcus Pimentel, rolling to his right, and that one is undercut, incomplete. Looked like it almost was an interception, but instead, it's a second straight fourth down stop for the Davenport defense.
Is 11 their punter? Is that why they tried to deceive us with the backup quarterback?
The punter is number 35, Lou Laidler.
Something different with the quarterback then.
Pimentel on the year is 15 for 32, 158 yards, one touchdown, one interception. He's also have two rushing touchdowns, so interesting move there by the Bulldogs. First play of the third drive is a give to Barrett Fallon, and a big sizable pickup for the sophomore running back. All the way down to the 41-yard line. Fallon had 19 carries, 129 yards, and three touchdowns versus Lamb Passes, and a 56-21 win. Doesn't go anywhere there on this carry. Good stop there by the front seven of Burnett. And we'll see Burnett run a 3-4 as well as a 4-2-5, trying to play the run as well as play some coverage. Fallon to Hamlin's right. Going to throw to the short side of the field. He gets Griman, a spin move, and a first down for Emmett Griman. Hamlin's pass
complete to number one. There's two philosophies on that. You just got to pressure a quarterback or you got to all-play coverage. I just don't know how they're going to let that good quarterback sit back there and throw all day.
A give now to Fallon. He falls forward. Pick up half the yardage there on first down. And that's the hard part about picking your poison as a defensive coordinator. Do you want to play and stop the run, or do you want to stop the pass? Because right. they've got over 500 yards per game, 300 in the air, 200 on the ground. They go to Fallon back on the ground, and he barrels over the corner of the Bulldogs. A big-time finish to that run, and a first down moves the chains. Griman to Hamlin's right, Fallon to his left. Two right wide receivers to the wide side. They give it to Griman. Hops over a defender. Gets all the way down to the 10-yard line.
So far, Davenport's pretty impressive on offense. They can run the ball just as well as they can throw it, and they're content to be patient and do lots of things. They're keeping Burnett guessing.
Three down linemen for Burnett. They put Fallon in motion. They give it up the middle to Griman, and he loses the ball. It's recovered in the end zone, and that's going to be a touchback for the Bulldogs. A huge turnover into the end zone, and the Burnett Bulldogs get a big-time stop as Davenport was looking to make this a two-score game.
That's a really big turnover, because not only do you get the ball, you stop them, and you get decent field position from that too. So fumbling in the end zone is no fun for the offense. But really nothing slowed them down other than a turnover. They'll be right back at that.
And they had one turnover last week for the Wolves. It was a fumble, but it was more of a miscommunication between Hamlin and the center, Armando Mesa. He was looking for a audible from the sideline. Mesa snapped the ball and ended up not hurting Davenport in that game. See how costly and how this defense can respond. First down pitch and catch for a first down for the Bulldogs. Nice pitch and catch there between Murray as well as number six, Aiden Sanchez.
Davenport is still in there, three down defense.
3-4 is their base defense. Denton to Slav. Actually, that is not Denton. And big hole there for Chris Kastner, a junior running back. Four touchdowns on the year, averaging 5.8 yards a carry. Picks up nine there on first down. Bulldogs taking their time, going no huddle, but much slower pace than the Wolves. 12 left on the play clock. Play action, looking for a deep shot. Grant Jones, and that one's just past the fingertips of Jones. Good coverage there from Jalen Morrow.
Not afraid to take a chance on second and short, try to get this to a even score game, tie score. Confidence in their offense that they can make this first down.
Jalen Morrow's got a big-time assignment trying to cover Grant Jones, averaging 113 yards per game through the air, 11 touchdowns. Also has a rushing touchdown on the year as he had 86 yards on the ground in that touchdown win versus Canyon Lake. Third and one from the 40. They give it to Kastner, and he is going to just have enough, and that'll move the chains with 2:09 left here in the first quarter.
It's burn its first first down. Second one. That's right, second one.
And both have been on this drive.
It seems so funny. They're really going pretty fast, but compared to Davenport, they feel, you know, slow motion.
And I think it's more because we feel like it's going fast because they're in the no huddle, but
right,
they're letting the play clock get to at least 10.
Yes.
There's a give now going left side. Good hold there. And number 35 for the Bulldogs, Noah. Excuse me, that's Lou Laidler with the carry. Lots of different running backs in this motion spread offense for Burnett. They'll switch out their running backs, H-backs, A-backs quite frequently.
Looks like a lot of their defensive starters are subbing in and out to play offense.
When you have athletes, you got to have them both ways in a big-time game against a nationally and state-ranked Davenport defense. A big-time tackle for loss for C.J. Turner. An open field tackle by the senior. And they backs him up all the way to Bulldog territory. At the 49, need the 47. Making some substitutions. Trying to get wide receiver in the game, number 14, Riley Howell. He's going to line up more as almost a offset tight end. Quick throw and catch. Another screen play and another first down for the Bulldogs.
They've run that play every time to that side. They must see something that they like in their blocking matchup, or maybe it's the fact that he's a right-handed quarterback, but they're doing a good job completing that and making some yards after the catch. They're going to let this wind down and be the end of the quarter.
So after one here from Davenport Stadium, it's the Wolves 7, the Bulldogs nothing. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
At Audi North Park, we believe that shopping for a car should be a positive experience. As the winner of both the Audi Magna Society Award and the J.D. Power Dealer of Excellence, Audi North Park strives for nothing but the best customer experience. From our receptionist to the service department, our team is committed to making you feel comfortable and respected. We know how difficult buying a car can be, which is why our brand specialists strive to inform and empower you to make the right choice. From the latest selection of new Audi models to our incredible variety of used cars, we have a model that will suit your lifestyle perfectly. Join the thousands of others who found the Audi of their dreams with the exceptional service at Audi North Park.
Ready for the second half here in San Antonio, Texas. The Davenport Wolves 7, the Burnett Bulldogs nothing. Sam Kamen alongside Brad Lind. And Brad, a very interesting first quarter. Lots of offense there, but not really any points to show for it.
Well, Davenport had that really big turnover. I think they might have gotten the ball back again quickly and scored another one had they not had that. But turnovers are devastating for their stat breakers for sure, because you look like, wow, why aren't we more points, but we don't have them.
They've been
got to hand it to Burnett, because they've been effective on offense. They don't have any points yet, but they've been effective keeping the ball away from Davenport. So that seems to be their game plan, and so far it's working. But they got to get some points on the board too.
They're looking to punch it in. Another time they've been in Davenport territory, the third straight possession. They've been stomped on fourth down twice. Second down from the 37. They're going to give it left side, and a great pursuit. Nice Zaire tackle. Livingston with the tackle.
Came all the way from this backside. He showed a lot of speed and beat two blockers to get there.
92 tackles on the season, averaging 11.5 per game. Had 12 last week, two tackles for loss, a sack, a fumble recovery, and a forced fumble. One of those three Wolves that was a all-star selection. Playing big time here. Third and five for the Bulldogs. Murray's going to look to the sideline. Denton to his left. Two wide receivers to the top. They're going to look for a double move. He's open, and that one is caught just in bounds. Wow. Colt Sanford able to drag the feet there on the sideline.
Well executed. Defense would like another shot at that, but that's a well executed throw and catch.
They'd been working for that one. They've been going screen, 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 and they finally get a double move. And that was actually Trenton Park with the reception on that far sideline. 19 receptions on the year, three touchdowns, 262 yards, and it's first and goal to go from the 10. Murray with Denton on his left. They're going to give it to Dash and trying to churn those feet. Picks up a couple there on first down. They've not had as much success running the ball as they have had throwing the ball so far, but
yeah, all their throws have been basically running plays just to get the ball to somebody in space and then let the blocker do the work. But they're other than that, what do you call that, a stop and go or block and go, they've set it up with the screen, so it's a really good job.
Screens have been seen as a part of that extension of the run game. And with
probably
5 seconds.
Get a timeout here.
Yeah. You can see Coach Wood walking towards that near side referee, and he is going to take a timeout. We'll take it with him. Bulldogs on the brink of their first points. 9:43 left here in the second quarter. 7-0 lead for Davenport.
What is up with Circus Burger social media? Everything says code moo. See? Code moo, code moo, code moo.
I don't get it either, but I mean, the generation is very different when it comes to the digital landscaping. Deb hired him.
Oh, okay.
Code moo.
We totally get it.
Do you get it?
No, I don't get it.
Okay.
My husband is not easy to surprise. We've been married for 11 years. I have not been able to surprise him one time. I coordinated with Tyler to surprise Matt with the baby reveal at Chick-fil-A.
I said, yeah, let's do this. This will be amazing.
I bought this onesie, and he's like, I got you covered.
We put it right on the tray for him.
Tyler's behind me on my right filming the whole thing.
Wait, no. Oh, my gosh. I was so surprised.
Mama Nugget.
And Papa Nugget.
Trick play out of the timeout, and it works to perfection. Grant Jones throws it to Marcus Pimentel, the wide receiver to the quarterback, and that's a good use of a timeout by head coach Bruce Wood.
When I was confused a while ago, they put number 11 in on a fourth down. Wondered why they were throwing that. They're setting that up to see if they were going to chase the real quarterback out the backside, and they didn't cover him. Sometimes in mad coverage, that's the last guy you think about.
Head coach Brian Wood in his second year there at Canyon Lake draws up a beauty there out of the timeout. And just like that, we've got a good one here at Davenport. All tied at seven between the Bulldogs and the Wolves. Burnett, 5-3 on the year. Have won their last two, a shutout victory versus Marble Falls 24-0. And then on the road, defeated Canyon Lake 45-24. But only one of their five wins have been against a team that is over 500, and all three of their losses have been to quality teams: Lavernia, who is 6-2, Brownwood, who is 8-1, and Lampasas, who is 6-2. So a win tonight would be monumental for this Burnett team.
Let's see if they try that short kick again. Didn't work out too well for them last time.
So 6:05 was taken on that touchdown drive. The Bulldogs go 80 yards as they turn in that turnover.
They took that turnover to a touchdown. That's a big momentum swing for them.
A 14-point swing as Griman was just a yard shy of the end zone, fumbles it into the end of the end zone, and the Bulldogs take it back. Here's Griman trying to make up for it, makes two guys miss, and all the way to the 45-yard line. Davenport has had some really good returns, and every time they've gotten the ball, they've had really good field position. They're going to mark it at the 44. So trying to bounce back off the turnover. Griman's going to line up in the tight end position with a hand in the ground. Fallon to the left of Hamlin. He's going to keep it. Picks up a couple before he meets a wall of Bulldogs.
That was really old-style play right there. That tight end did what we used to call the art block, just like out of the old Wishbone playbook and split back veer. That's an interesting play. When it's out of the shotgun, it looks different, but it's still just a good way to run the football.
The option and Wishbone have kind of made their rounds of evolving. Here's a RPO, deflected, but still caught.
Great number concentration by number six.
De'Anthony Moore with the catch and the first down. Here goes the tempo for Davenport. Going to stay with the two-back set, Griman and Fallon. They're going to give it to Fallon. A nice patient run. Burst through the hole all the way inside the 30. Another first down for the Wolves.
Looks like the quarterback's reading the safety on that. So that's the other part of the RPO. That's the R part.
Two-back set. They're going to keep it. Going to look for a guy. And that was really just a throw out of bounds.
Yeah.
Miscommunication between Kyler Payne and Tristan Hamlin. What's the difference on that play versus some of the other plays that he's kept and been able to find completions?
That one was just a long run play action and like you said, miscommunication with receivers. But the other ones, you just watch the quarterback's helmet looking downfield on his handoffs.
And whistles before the snap. It's going to be a false start on the Wolves, so they'll back up 5 yards.
Yeah. We can't see the quarterback's eyes from here, but you can see that he's looking downfield, reading a linebacker or probably the safety, and that's who they read on an RPO, because if the safety doesn't come downhill, then you feel like you've got an advantage blocking for the run play.
So it's switched from reading the edge defender of an outside linebacker to the safety.
Safety, that's what RPO usually means for coaches.
Fallon to Hamlin's right, trips to the wide side of the field. RPO there, a little bit behind Dante Singletary. He got hit right as he was trying to make the catch, unable to hang on. So third down from the 31, have to get to the 16, 15 yards. Miles Mendez, the field goal kicker, 4 for 5 on the year, a long of 38. That would mean you have to get to about the 21-yard line. Rolling to Hamlin's left, able to get it inside.
Missed
a missed tackle and a touchdown. Dante Singletary kind of was in the soft of the zone, was expecting to get hit, did not get hit, and he sneaks his way into the end zone.
It's hard to tackle in space, and kids are successful doing it so often you get used to it, but that's not an easy play, and that was well executed by the receiver. Like you said, he assumed he was going to get hit, but once he caught the ball, he was clean.
4 touchdowns in the last 2 weeks for Dante Singletary. He had three last week versus Lampasas. Picks up a big one as they're able to reclaim the lead. 8-11 left here in the second quarter. 14-7 lead for Davenport. You are watching Texas High School Football on the Wolf Sports Network.
Hold on to your horses because it's back. Unless you didn't know about it, in which case, it's here. The Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit is back and here for a limited time at Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Eight-11 left here in the first half. Davenport able to get back on top. A big third down conversion.
Overcame a penalty during that drive too, so did a good job.
Third and 15, and it was a 31-yard touchdown for Dante Singletary. 56-yard drive, taking 1:19 off the play clock. So we've seen a 40-second drive, a minute 19 second drive, and a 6 minute drive. Pooch punt there. Bulldogs will have it.
Both teams not really wanting to kick it deep. Both of them must have good return games.
Already seen Grant Jones make a return that got stopped just on the other side of midfield. Emmett Griman for Davenport having a couple good returns.
And then Burnett had that reverse. It was very successful for them. Created good field position.
So they'll try to build off of a touchdown drive. The first two drives stopped on fourth down. They've been moving the ball, and then they go the full length of the field. 80 yards, 6 minutes taken off the clock. They're winning the time of possession battle, trying to keep the Davenport offense off the field. Swing pass to Denton, and he is dropped back for a loss. Zaire Livingston living in that backfield. Pass complete to number one, Dash Denton. Met by 43, brought us five, Livingston. Three, last year for Livingston, 17 tackles, a tackle for loss, a QB hurry, and a fumble recovery. Versus Burnett, he has feasted when it comes to district play. Had 122 tackles last season. Is about to be on pace for that same mark. Needs only 8 to get over 100 on the season. Rolling to his right is Murray, caught, but immediately dragged down. Garner Krause with the catch. And quickly tackled by Trenton Evans Williams. Will create third and long for the Bulldogs.
See if they like that screenplay over here to Davenport's bench. They've been running it the other way when they were going, I guess, north. Now that they're going south, they have to run that favorite play to Davenport side. Let's see if they want to do it. Probably not with just one receiver.
They got to hurry. Four on the play clock. Three wide receivers to the wide side. They're going to throw a slant and caught over the middle. It's enough for first down yardage.
Nice read by the quarterback there to give the receiver enough room to catch that and come down safely before the safety made his tackle.
Number six, Aiden Sanchez with the catch. Another huge catch. Third down conversions are going to be key for the Bulldogs, trying to keep this Davenport offense off the field and sustain drives as they try to kind of shorten the game, playing time of possession. Rhett Murray is going to give it. And another tackle in the backfield. Zaire Livingston, as well as Tate Broadus.
Term I heard last night on TV was complementary football. Doing things on defense that help your offense. Doing things on offense that help your defense, besides just making first downs and scoring. Interesting concept.
Do you think it's complimentary football as well on this Davenport team that, as long as you can score on every possession, your defense is going to get some
yeah,
stops.
It'd be fun to be a defensive player because
you're always out there.
Just kind of turn it loose and have fun.
Two wide receivers to the wide side.
Oh,
and
no
a
good.
Timeout or a false start. They're going to give the timeout to Coach Wood. We'll take him with it. 5:15 remaining in the first half. 14-7 lead for Davenport. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
Get a shake with your points and some fries on the side with your points.
You get more with every order.
Woo! Get a Whataburger or a patty melt or some breakfast with the points.
You get more with every order.
Get a biscuit or a brownie. But no matter what you pick, you get more.
More. Like your favorite Whataburger or whatever, cause it all gives you more with Whataburger rewards.
Not the fun part of being a dad, but I have to speak to you about something that is concerning me.
Concerning you?
Yeah. Heard you and your mother talking about this Arlo fella, and
Arlo?
I wasn't eavesdropping. He's always watching you.
Second and 10 for Burnett at their own 44, dropping back to pass. Going to take a long throw. They're looking for Jones. And again, just off the fingertips.
Just got to make that play work if you want to be successful for Burnett. They did a good job with the move, found a hole in the coverage. You just got to execute and make that catch and throw.
Jones has been pretty sure-handed. 33 receptions. Their leading receiver is the senior. And that's a long throw for Rhett Murray.
Yeah, from this hash mark to the other sideline, that's a deep throw.
And they're going to make a quarterback change once again on third down. Back to Marcus Pimentel.
Comes a trick play.
Twins to each side. They're going to fake a quarterback run. They pull Denton out of the backfield. A big time first down once again. Pimentel, the trick play master.
That was a dirty little play right there. Fake the quarterback draw and then pull back and throw it. It's a Tim Tebow play. He just didn't jump.
Exactly. So Murray's back into the game. Denton comes out. Lou Laidler in at running back. Trips to the wide side of the field. First and 10 at the 35. Laidler now to the right of Murray. Going to give it to Laidler going left side. Flag comes in.
Got a holding on that sideways run. Usually have to reach out and stop somebody, a defensive player, and most of the time to do that, there's a hold.
And this will back him up 10 yards. So instead of being second and 5 ahead of the chains, they're going to be behind it with first and 20. Burnett's like that zone run going kind of horizontal all the way parallel to the field and then finding a hole to go vertical.
They're pulling two guards and getting those kids out to block, but somebody on the edge has got to stop their edge player from getting wide, and so it's either a great block or a hold, depending on whose mom and dad you are.
So they'll stick with this trips left formation. Laidler to Murray's right. Back to pass, another slant, and that somehow snuck around C.J. Turner. Turner was blanketing number 10, Trenton Park, and Park able to haul it in.
That's great coverage, and then still executed the catch.
They've liked this trips left package. Laidler switches from the right to the left of Murray. Tunnel screen to Park. And he's immediately dropped at the 35. First one there was Tate Broadus.
Sooner or later, they're going to come over here to the single side. They're not giving this cornerback that's in single coverage with number 4, they're not giving him much help at all. That's the The successful blitzer has come from this side, which means he can't be in underneath defender, and the safety's been cheating over to Trips. So let's see if they do it to the short side of the field now.
Yeah, the Trips to the wide side of the field. You got Grant Jones and what looks like single coverage to the top of the screen. Murray is going to give it to Laidler, and he picks up a couple, trying to get it to fourth and manageable. They're on third and 10, only able to pick up two. So fourth and 8 from the 33, got to get to the 25. 2:33 left here in the first half.
They'd like a score, but they're kind of playing defense with their offense right now. They've run 6 minutes off the clock in this second quarter. Davenport's had the ball one time with a score. But that's it for the quarter. One possession is not what you want when you're fast and can score all the time.
They're going to let this clock go all the way to one and take their final timeout. Davenport's got all three remaining. So we'll take one final timeout before the end of the half. 2:04 here from Davenport Stadium. 14-7 lead for the Wolves. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
What is up with Circus Burger social media? Everything says code moo. See? Code moo, code moo, code moo.
I don't get it either, but I mean, the generation is very different when it comes to the digital landscaping. Deb hired him.
Oh, okay.
Code moo.
We totally get it.
Do you get it?
No, I don't get
it. Okay.
At Audi North Park, we believe that shopping for a car should be a positive experience. As a winner of both the Audi Magnus Society Award and the J.D. Power Dealer of Excellence, Audi North Park strives for nothing but the best customer experience. From our receptionist to the service department, our team is committed to making you feel comfortable and respected. We know how difficult buying a car can be, which is why our brand specialists strive to inform and empower you to make the right choice. From the latest.
So the offense stays on the field with 2:04. Murray in the backfield. Looking for a deep shot. He's got Jones,
wow.
And it's a touchdown.
Wow.
Back-to-back drives. Burnett has taken a timeout and on the very next play has put it in for 6. Grant Jones with the touchdown. His 12th of the year, and they're a PAT away from tying this game back up.
27 Rodriguez offered the extra point.
Sam Rodriguez to kick. Snap, spot, hold.
Kick is good.
And it's good. All square at 14. Could have been that turnover, like you said, kind of gave that Burnett side some momentum as they were able to inject some life to the offense, saying, hey, we can get a stop. They take their next two drives offensively, put it in for scores, and they're keeping up with this Davenport Dynamite offense.
Well, the last 4 or 5 games, Davenport has kind of scored at will. I guess their punter didn't get to play much, you know, kind of thing. But the Davenport coaches will have to tell their kids, hey, we're not losing. We're doing okay. We're doing just fine in this half. It's just that Burnett found a way to take the air out of the ball, like we say in basketball.
Another 6-minute, 9-second drive by Burnett. 2 touchdown drives. That last one went 72 yards. So 2 touchdown drives that have taken 12 minutes off the play clock. That's a full quarter.
Now, unfortunately, they have to kick off, and they've been giving Davenport great field position with these short kicks.
And the Wolves have all 3 timeouts. They received the opening kickoff, so they'll try to put some points on the board before the end of the half. Fielded by De'Anthony Moore on the pooch punt.
This is still really good field position, but this is the worst field position they've had after a kickoff.
Worst field position, but you're still at on the other side of the 35. You'll take that any day of the week. And this is an offense that you'd rather put at the 20 or 15 and make them really go the full length of the field. So 1:51 to work with. All three timeouts. Hamlin has Fallon to his left. They're going to fake a screen. Moved out of the pocket. Pressured was Hamlin, and he just throws that one away.
That's a long time to cover for some really good receivers. Burnett's doing a good job.
Tried to go to kind of that block-and-go type of screen to the wide side of the field. Unable to connect and find an open man down the field. So second and 10 from the 37. Fake the swing pass. Instead, it's a screen to Daniel Soakup the second. And a good tackle.
Clearly a block in the back on the guy that made on the player that made the tackle. So that'll move him back.
It was a 1 yard gain, so it'd be 3rd and 9 if they decline with 1:37. Or does Coach Wood back him up and make it 2nd and 20? Umpires are discussing this one. And instead of a block in the back, it's a holding, so about the same difference.
Yeah.
And they will move him back.
It's the way that penalty was called, way back here from the back of the secondary, then it's holding on one of those wide receiver blocks.
So 2nd and long, Fallon to Hamlin's left, two wide receivers to the short side of the field. Griman has the tight end. Being pressured is Hamlin, trying to loft one up to Griman, and he drops it in the bucket at the 45. That'll be short of the first down. Clock will continue to roll. They've got all three timeouts.
Burnett
3rd and 1.
Burnett brought 6 that time. Tried to blitz a linebacker and rushed 5.
They bring a lot here. Able to hit Soakup on the slant. Gets all the way to the 40. Clock will stop as they reset the chains. 58 seconds left. Still have all three timeouts. Twins to both sides. Fallon to Hamlin's left. Back to pass. Checks it down to Barrett Fallon, and he will get out of bounds. 42 seconds. Still have all three timeouts in the back pocket. Can use the entire field. But a smart play there by Fallon to get out of bounds and conserve one of those timeouts. So two wide receivers to the top of the screen. Griman has the tight end on the short side. Hamlin being pressured, throws it off his back foot, and that one was dangerous, almost picked off by number 20, Chris Kastner.
Barnett brought 6 again on the blitz. So
they're deciding to bring more pressure. See if they can't get to Hamlin, have caused him to throw a little bit more off his back foot, can't step into as many throws, have made him move off platform as well. 3rd and 8 from the 38. Check down to Griman. Has a first down. And just outside the 25, clock will stop with 29 seconds. Still choosing not to take a timeout. Clock beginning to roll now as it is set. Trips to the far side. Rolls to the short side as Hamlin. And trying to get a corner or a
comeback route
to Singletary. Good break on the ball by Jacob Atkinson. 18 seconds remain, 2nd and 10.
Tried to catch him in single coverage, but I think they were lucky enough to have a linebacker drop underneath, make that hard throw.
26-yard line is where they're at. Trips to the far side of the field. Fallon to Hamlin's left. Three-step drop, moving out of the pocket is Hamlin, looking for people, and he's going to just tuck it down and run out of bounds. 11 seconds left in the first half. He got to the 16. And so it's going to be, let's see if they're going to give it to him. Both of the referees are looking, and they will move the chains. Well, yes, they are going to move the chains. It's a lot of confusion on the far sideline, but it's first and 10. 11 seconds.
Play
so you,
clock is still running.
You think you only probably got two plays left. Soak up motions to the far side. Hamlin flushed out near side. He'll get out of bounds about where the marker was. 5 seconds left. Smart play. No one was open.
Yeah.
Able to hang on to the ball. So not many times you get to have a field goal attempt for Davenport, but Miles Mendez has been good. Has only missed one in PAT.
It's 32 yards, right?
4 for 5 on the year.
32
yarder. Kick is up, and it is through. So Miles Mendez sends Davenport into the locker room with a 17-14 lead. What a great half there. Sam Kamen alongside Brad Lynn. Kind of break down that first half. What have you seen from both sides?
Well, nobody wants a moral victory in district. So Burnett's not going to tell their kids they're doing great when they're behind, but you've got to like their effort and you've got to like their game plan to hold this offense to just 17 points. Davenport had an untimely penalty that stopped a drive, and then they had a fumble in the end zone. This could have been one of those other games that where they lit the scoreboard up. But I think both teams did what they wanted to do. Davenport's probably a little frustrated, but Burnett has a chance, and not too many people probably gave him one, so we'll see what happens in the second half.
It's going to be a good second half as we have reached halftime from Davenport Stadium. The Wolves with a 17-14 lead here on senior night. We'll take a step aside and get you ready for the second half after these halftime festivities. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
Hi's for Kat. All right, there you go. Have a good day.
My grandmother actually inspired me to become a teacher. She was a custodian in school, and she always looked at the teachers and wanted to become one of them.
My top goal is to be a NICU nurse, but I'm also really interested in mental health, and I want to help people.
I was fortunate enough to earn my pilot's license in high school and have loved flying. That's what I want to do in the future. I love aviation.
Right now I'm in college for business. I want to work in fair trade coffee farming. I lived in Papua New Guinea with farmers, and I just really would love to see families be supported by buyers.
I'm John with Chick-fil-A. I want to congratulate you. You've just won the $25,000 True Inspiration Scholarship.
Absolutely overwhelmed at the moment. I had no idea any of this was happening. I am so extremely grateful that I've been given this opportunity.
I was really worried about having to pay for school. Now with the scholarship, I won't have to worry as much and I can focus on my education.
Gracias a Dios que no problema.
Tienes que decirlo porque estás orgulloso de mí.
Porque tienes ganas de salir adelante.
And you're going out and going to change this world, so never forget that.
The level of character and hard work and dedication you bring to this job is going to serve you well the rest of your life. Just bring it. There's no way you won't be successful.
Working with Ed at another brand, and we were there for 4 or 5 years, and he left and came to Whataburger and asked me to join him.
She was a very great cashier up front, very personable with the customers. They just loved her and they kept coming back.
Well, I retired from a school district in 2016, and I needed a little extra income after I retired. And I was having a conversation with my daughter one day, telling her I just really need a part-time job. And she said, "Mom, come and work at Whataburger." And I thought, could I do that? Could I really do that? And I did, and it is the best stress-free job I have ever had.
I first started with Whataburger around July of 2019. I got involved because of my mom, and once I turned 18, I moved up to a team leader, and then about 3-4 months after, I was moved up to manager.
I can't believe she's 19 and she's a manager. When she was young, she was very shy, but as soon as she started working at Whataburger, I saw her blossom. I am over proud, so proud.
We're so proud of you.
The Haynes branch has been in existence and functioning since the early 1950s. We're trying our best to keep it going. It's a routine. It's every day. There's always something going on, something to be fixed. Fences, a bull gets out.
You could be working cattle and they just start acting up and aren't having it for the day. So you kind of have to be prepared for anything to happen.
It's a lot of fun, but it's a lot of work as well.
It's gotten to the point where it kind of just really flows. We're comfortable with each other and we all trust each other to where you can kind of count on those friendships outside of work even.
Our Whataburger family, I wouldn't want to be anywhere else. I mean, if I have to ask off to help with cattle, they're willing to do that because they know now that twice a year I have to be with my family. It's just an awesome place to work.
People that want to work for Whataburger just need to have an open mind. You're gonna have a lot of new experiences, doing things you have never done. For example, a few of the employees never even had to mop before. Just something that you teach them and then they'll teach somebody else how to mop when they come in. We have really clean floors.
My first day, I felt connected. Ed just treated me so nice and didn't treat me like a stranger. He treated me like I was his daughter.
Well, I mean, it's a family, bottom line. And you feel that when you come to work for Whataburger. When I came in today, it's all hugs. Got me a little misty. Even now.
I love my experience here at Whataburger. I love when I walk in and I see everybody's faces, especially my mom's, that everybody's happy. Knowing that when I come to work, it's really not work. I'm here with my family.
You guys are why we are able to function day in and day out, and we are entirely grateful for you. Thank you all.
I'd like to thank the custodians for keeping our home clean and taking care of all of our area, making sure everything's always clean.
Thank you, custodians, for taking the time out of your day to clean up the school's messes.
Thank you, custodians, for keeping our school clean, cleaning up the messes we made at our school, and coming here, working hard every day to keep the school beautiful.
Whenever I do have to call and say, maybe there's a scary animal or a snake, they always come running, and we really appreciate and love them. Thank you.
Thank you, custodians, for cleaning our school. I appreciate y'all cleaning our school, and y'all do a very good job.
Thank you to our entire maintenance team for always taking care of our school.
You are amazing.
Thank you for everything you do and all the hard work you put in to keep our school clean.
Thank you for keeping our hallways and our athletic areas clean.
To all the maintenance and operations and custodial teams, thank you so much for keeping our facilities running all day and everything nice and clean.
Thank you guys for all y'all do. We are so appreciative of what y'all do. And for all the schools, thank y'all so much.
We know that you do so many things behind the scenes to keep us up and running. So on behalf of the administration team, we just want to say
thank you.
Thank you.
So, where are we eating?
With GVTC's blazing fast fiber speeds.
3.5 stars, not a chance we try anything under 4.
You might feel like other things in life are taking a little longer than before.
Ooh, what sounds better, La Fiesta or Dumpling Palace?
Dumpling Palace.
Ew, gross.
We may not be able to speed up your dinner decisions, but we can provide fast and consistent premium Wi-Fi to search all the available options. Enjoy the GVTC difference, and please be patient with things that may have seemed to...
Wait, what are we gonna watch?
Slow down a bit. GVTC, connecting you.
Hey, buddy. Got your glove?
Yep, I got it right here. You're coming, right?
Of course. I'll see you in 10 minutes.
Awesome.
Don't forget the you-know-whats.
Whether you're gearing up for a big project or a big game, GVTC has everything you need to stay connected.
What do you think?
They are going to love these.
From smart security and high-speed internet to TV and phone, GVTC provides cutting-edge technology for your home and business.
Thank you.
You made it.
Hey, what is it?
Whoa, jersey! Yes.
With deep roots in the community, we're committed to building a stronger, better, connected future for the areas we serve. Our GVTC Foundation's charitable support and industry-leading products help you stay connected to what matters most. GVTC, connecting you.
One of the most common questions kids are asked is, what do you want to be when you grow up? For some, that may be an easy question to answer, but for others, it may seem impossible. That is where our school counselors, academic advisors, and our teachers can help. In the coming weeks, our 8th grade students will begin planning for their high school journey, and our 5th graders will begin planning for middle school. In Comau ISD, we continue to grow greatness, and one of our major objectives is to empower our students to be prepared to attend college, start a career, or enlist in the military beyond high school graduation. This is known as CCMR, College Career Military Readiness. The Texas Education Agency offers many ways of recognizing students who have met CCMR requirements, from demonstrating college readiness with qualified exams earning industry certifications in various career and technical education programs, to enlisting in our armed forces. From dual credit and AP courses to CTE classes, we continue to offer students a variety of ways to achieve the CCMR goals and to help them easily answer that ultimate question, what do I want to be when I grow up? What we need is you. I want to encourage you as parents to help us. Your partnership in your child's education is vital to their success. No matter what path they choose, they need guidance, support, and reassurance. They need you to ask them questions about their interests, to go with them on their visits with their counselors, and encourage them to use every resource that is available to them. Together, we will grow greatness.
Hello. In this video, we'll walk you through how to set up and mount your Arlo wire-free camera in just a few simple steps. Let's get started. To begin, open the Arlo app and make sure you're connected to your home network. From the Arlo app, select Add Device, Cameras, and then Arlo Essential. If you don't already have the free app, you can download it from the App Store and create an account. The Arlo app will help you complete setup and guide you through the installation process. Now, follow the prompts in the app to connect to a 2.4 GHz network and enter your Wi-Fi credentials. If you don't have a 2.4 GHz network, you will need to create one or contact your network administrator to enable it. Next, press and hold the round white sync button on the bottom of the Arlo camera for 1 to 2 seconds. The LED light on the front of the camera will start to flash blue. Hold your camera approximately 4 to 6 inches away from the QR code displayed in the app. You will hear a chime from the camera once the QR code has been successfully scanned. The camera will automatically be found on the Arlo app. Give your camera a unique name to help identify it later. If your camera is not found, repeat the sync steps again until the blue light is flashing. Once your camera is set up, it will automatically look for updates. This can take a few minutes. If you have multiple cameras, you will repeat the setup steps for each unit. Find a location to mount your camera outside your home or business with a clear vantage point. You'll also want to ensure that the location you select has a strong Wi-Fi signal for the best experience. Check the signal strength here. A strong signal is indicated with the color bar reaching green on the far right. After you've found the ideal location, you'll want to install the mount. Next, attach your camera to the mount. Tighten the back of the mount to ensure a tight fit. You can adjust the angle by turning the thumb screw counterclockwise. Once you've positioned your camera to the desired angle, turn the thumb screw clockwise to lock the position in place.
Get a shake with your points and some fries on the side with your points.
You get more with every order.
Woo! Get a Whataburger or a patty melt or some breakfast with the points.
You get more with every order.
Get a biscuit or a brownie, but no matter what you pick, you get more.
Like your favorite Whataburger or whatever, cause it all gives you more with Whataburger rewards.
So, where are we eating?
With GVTC's blazing fast fiber speeds.
3.5 stars, not a chance we try anything under 4.
You might feel like other things in life are taking a little longer than before.
Ooh, what sounds better, La Fiesta or Dumpling Palace?
Ooh, Dumpling Palace.
Ew, gross.
We may not be able to speed up your dinner decisions, but we can provide fast and consistent premium Wi-Fi to search all the available options. Enjoy the GVTC difference, and please be patient with things that may have seemed to...
Wait, what are we gonna watch?
Slow down a bit. GVTC, connecting you.
Wow.
What is up with Circus Burger social media? Everything says code moo. See? Code moo, code moo, code moo.
I don't get it either, but I mean, the generation is very different when it comes to the digital landscaping. And, well, Deb hired him.
Oh, okay.
Code moo.
We totally get it.
Do you get it?
No, I don't get
it. Okay.
Get a shake with your points and some fries on the side with your points.
You get more with every order.
Woo! Get a Whataburger or a patty melt or some breakfast with the point.
You get more with every order.
Get a biscuit or a brownie, but no matter what you pick, you get more. More.
Like your favorite Whataburger or whatever, cause it all gets you more with Whataburger rewards.
Appreciate you.
You guys are why we are able to function day in and day out, and we are entirely grateful for you. Thank you all.
I'd like to thank the custodians for keeping our home clean and taking care of all of our area, making sure everything's always clean.
Thank you, custodians, for taking the time out of your day to clean up the school's messes.
Thank you, custodians, for keeping our school clean, cleaning up the messes we made at our school, and coming here working hard every day to keep the school beautiful.
Whenever I do have to call and say maybe there's a scary animal or a snake, they always come running, and we really appreciate and love them. Thank you.
Thank you, custodians, for cleaning our school. I appreciate y'all cleaning our school, and y'all do a very good job.
Thank you to our entire maintenance team for always taking care of our school.
You
are
amazing.
Thank you for everything you do and all the hard work you put in to keep our school clean.
Thank you for keeping our hallways and our athletic areas clean.
To all the maintenance and operations and custodials teams, thank you so much for keeping our facilities running all day and everything nice and clean.
Thank you guys for all y'all do. We are so appreciative of what y'all do. And for all the schools, thank y'all so much.
We know that you do so many things behind the scenes to keep us up and running. So on behalf of the administration team, we just want to say
thank you.
Thank you.
One of the most common questions kids are asked is, what do you want to be when you grow up? For some, that may be an easy question to answer, but for others, it may seem impossible. That is where our school counselors, academic advisors, and our teachers can help. In the coming weeks, our 8th grade students will begin planning for their high school journey, and our 5th graders will begin planning for middle school. In Kamau ISD, we continue to grow greatness, and one of our major objectives is to empower our students to be prepared to attend college, start a career, or enlist in the military beyond high school graduation. This is known as CCMR, College Career Military Readiness. The Texas Education Agency offers many ways of recognizing students who have met CCMR requirements, from demonstrating college readiness with qualified exams, earning industry certifications in various career and technical education programs, to enlisting in our armed forces. From dual credit and AP courses to CTE classes, we continue to offer students a variety of ways to achieve the CCMR goals and to help them easily answer that ultimate question, what do I want to be when I grow up? What we need is you. I want to encourage you as parents to help us. Your partnership in your child's education is vital to their success. No matter what path they choose, they need guidance, support, and reassurance. They need you to ask them questions about their interests, to go with them on their visits with their counselors, and encourage them to use every resource that is available to them. Together, we will grow greatness.
Eating.
With GVTC's blazing fast fiber speeds.
3.5 stars, not a chance we try anything under 4.
You might feel like other things in life are taking a little longer than before.
Ooh, what sounds better, La Fiesta or Dumpling Palace?
Ooh, Dumpling Palace.
Ew, gross.
We may not be able to speed up your dinner decisions, but we can provide fast and consistent premium Wi-Fi to search all the available options. Enjoy the GVTC difference. And please be patient with things that may have seemed to...
Wait. What are we going to watch?
Slow down a bit. GVTC. Connecting you.
What is up with Circus Burger social media? Everything says code moo, see? Code moo, code moo, code moo.
I don't get it either, but I mean, the generation is very different when it comes to the digital landscaping. Deb hired him.
Oh, okay.
Code moo.
We totally get it.
Do you get it?
No, I don't get it.
Okay.
My husband is not easy to surprise. We've been married for 11 years. I have not been able to surprise him one time. I coordinated with Tyler to surprise Matt with the baby reveal at Chick-fil-A.
I said, yeah, let's do this. This will be amazing.
I bought this onesie and he's like, I got you covered.
We put it right on the tray for him.
Tyler's behind me at my right filming the whole thing.
Wait, no. Oh my gosh, I was so surprised.
Mama Nugget.
And Papa Nugget.
That is awesome.
Wi-Fi!
Got the tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
Just about set for the second half here from Davenport Stadium. At the half, it was Davenport with a 17-14 lead over the Burnett Bulldogs. A big key District 13 matchup between a 2-1 Bulldog team and an undefeated Davenport team. Sam came alongside my color analyst, Brad Lind, and a very intriguing first half. Davenport came with an early punch, scoring on their first drive within the first 41 seconds.
Three plays, 41 seconds, yeah.
And then kind of sputtered. They were going in for a touchdown, and Emmett Griman fumbles into the end zone, a touchback, and that's what kind of kicked the Bulldog offense into gear.
Yeah, they took advantage of either the ball got knocked out, or either way, they took advantage of the fact that that Davenport didn't get to score, and then they took the ball. The interesting numbers of 28 plays for Davenport and 33 for Burnett, I think we would have won some bets as fast as Davenport goes that they would have had more plays. But Burnett did some interesting things on defense and some really interesting things on offense to bleed that clock down. You mentioned it several times. They weren't snapping the football until it was inside 10 seconds on the play clock every time.
Yeah, two touchdown drives that were over 6 minutes apiece. One was going 80 yards, another 72 yards. Some first half stats for you. For Davenport starting off, 13 of 16 was Tristan Hamlin, 160 yards and a touchdown, also ran for 10 yards as well. Barrett Fallon, 51 yards on 7 carries and a touchdown. Emmett Griman doing it both in the running game and passing game. 7 touches total, 5 of those receptions, 97 total yards. Having the big fumble on the ground, 80 yards receiving. And then another touchdown for Dante Singletary, his 4th in 2 weeks, 2 receptions for 47 yards. And on the other side for Burnett, 14 of 18 is Rhett Murray, 140 yards, 2 touchdowns. And they've had a couple big plays. And Rhett Murray's only got
fourth
one touchdown. Yeah.
Fourth down big plays, yeah.
Rhett Murray had one of the touchdowns, and then a trick play with Marcus Pimentel was another touchdown play. They'll get the ball to start the second half as there's a pooch kick there from Miles Mendez. A fair catch by Burnett caught at the 26-yard line, and that's where the Bulldogs will start this second half.
Yeah, this first 5 minutes of the second half, the first 5 minutes of the third quarter, really important for both teams to see if they understand the adjustments the coaches wanted to make, see if those adjustments even make sense, because the other team's making adjustments too. So we'll figure out if Burnett has a plan to both hold the ball and get another score.
If you're J.D. Zimmer Hansel for Davenport, what adjustments do you make in trying to stop this Burnett offense that was moving the ball and then has punched in for 2 touchdowns their last 2 drives?
Well, one turnover is enough, not enough to get really excited about, but you're probably talking to your defensive kids and your defensive coaches about not getting frustrated by Burnett slowing the game down. Just keep playing solid defense and making good tackles, and then the offense will get their chances.
There was a good tackle there, stopping Dash Denton for a short gain. So 2nd and 8. And they've gone no huddle the entire game, but it's that delayed no huddle. 18 on the play clock, trips to the far side. They've liked this type of formation. Back to pass is Murray looking across the middle and at a contested grab there. Colt
Great
Sanford.
Great coverage, and he made the catch anyway.
On the coverage was Eric Singletary. The safety was blanketing Sanford.
They're using a route where the inside receiver runs a flare, so he gets the underneath cover guy to go with him, and then those two deep slants or short posts, the quarterback kind of picks and chooses which one he wants, and he's been successful several times so far.
So they got trips to the short side of the field. Dash Denton to the left of Murray. They're going to set up a screen caught by Grant Jones, and he is hit hard there on the sideline. Got all the way to the 40 as the tackle was by Cole Bourne. So a gain of 7 for Grant Jones. 2 touchdowns last week. Over 250 yards, 179 receiving, 86 on the ground. Trips to the wide side of the field once again. They'll move Denton from the left side of Murray to the right. Another quick screen there out on the edge. And a
first
tackle
down
right about the 36, but that will move the chains. Trenton Park with another reception.
very disciplined, very patient to make sure that they don't get in a hurry after successful plays. They want to eat up that game clock and the play clock.
And this is a Davenport team that just 2 weeks ago here at home, they scored 70 versus Canyon Lake, scoring 10 touchdowns. They've only had 5 possessions in that first half, making with this kind of play clock style that Burnett has, you got to cash in on every single opportunity. Check down there for Murray. A nice move, making a couple Wolves miss in space. All the way to the 30-yard line is Trenton Park.
That 40-second game clock rule that they changed about 6 years ago, both for NCAA and Texas, of course, playing NCAA rules, has really changed the makeup of teams going fast and the teams that like to eat the clock. You can clearly see how much is on the game clock and the play clock every time.
Second and medium, back to pass, trying to take a shot over the middle. A DB falls down for Davenport. Grant
almost,
Jones
almost
was
made the catch anyway.
Yeah, Grant Jones, the intended receiver. He's had a couple one-on-one opportunities. Just an overthrow there from Murray.
Yeah, they'll take two plays if they need to make this first down.
And they go back to that trips to the far side. That wide side of the field, 3rd and 3. 8:40 left on the play clock. The game clock, under 10 on the play clock. Denton to Murray's right. They will give it to Dash, and he is up for a first down. Cut down inside the 25, and that will move the sticks.
That kind of play puts a lot of pressure on that outside linebacker to the wide side of the field. He's got a receiver to cover in a lot of space, and he's got to stop that run, and they ran it right at him while he was moving to stop the pass.
So they're continuing to go 3 down linemen. Three-man front. 2 linebackers. Quick screen to the outside. Bursting through. Good sizable pickup there for Trenton Park. He has been busy here on this drive.
Referee's wasting no time starting that clock.
His third catch of the drive. He's got over 57 yards receiving now. 2nd and 3. So they go from trips left to trips right. Near side is the wide side of the field. Dash to Murray's left. Give to Dash. He'll fall inside the 15. And that will continue to slowly and methodically move those chains. And continue to see more and more time click off the top clock.
Yeah. It's already more than a 5-minute drive.
Is it just them getting the play call in late, or is it more of, hey, we're going to...
I think they're doing it on purpose. They've done it the whole first half, and they're really, really being successful with it right now.
Trips to the short side of the field. They fake the quick screen. He's get popped. Is Murray with the hurry was Zaire Livingston.
Yeah, they brought a linebacker that time. They weren't content with a 3-man rush.
Again, looking for that inside receiver in that trips formation. It was Colt Sanford. Stanford, who already had the big catch to get him into Davenport territory. Now behind the chains a little bit, 2nd and 10 from the Wolves 14. Trips left, Denton to Murray's right. He's got a quick slant and diving
touchdown
for the end zone. They're gonna mark him just short. He reached for the end zone. They're gonna say his knee was down. Grant Jones with the 15-yard reception and a first and goal from the 1 yard line for the Bulldogs. Denton in the backfield. Josiah Hill acts as a H-back right behind the right guard. And trying to punch it in, and he does. Dash Denton able to give Burnett back the lead. 20-17 with a PAT upcoming.
Got to be impressed with execution and patience. Sometimes those two things don't go together because you're excited when you're making plays and you want to hurry up, and your coaches are doing a good job of slowing the pace down. Even a coach wants to call more plays.
Whistles there as the PAT is up and good. Might have gotten a quick jump was Davenport. I'm going to call offsides, but they will decline it. So the PAT is up and good. 5:57 left here in the third quarter. Burnett takes their first drive of the second half for a touchdown. They'll lead by four now here at Davenport Stadium. You are watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network. .57 left here in the third quarter. A short kick. Trying to reverse the field is DeAnthony Moore. He's got a seam. He's past midfield. He breaks the block and knocked out of bounds by the kicker. So once again, Davenport with great field position. They'll start in plus territory. A big time game saving tackle for Sam Rodriguez as he kept DeAnthony Moore out of the end zone. That last drive for Burnett took 6:01 off the clock, 75 yards and a touchdown. Three straight touchdown drives for the Bulldogs, all three of them 6-plus minutes off the clock. First play for Davenport is a run up the middle by Barrett Fallon, and they're going to make the adjustment of going even faster.
Faster now, yeah.
They want to maximize as many possessions as possible. Second and short. Another give to Fallon. He's been the workhorse. And he gets another good 5-6 yards. He's averaging 6.2 yards a carry. Has over 1,000 yards rushing. And he's got 21 total touchdowns on the season. 18 on the ground, 3 as a receiver. First down, drop back pass for Hamlin. He's flushed up into the pocket, finds Fallon for a check down. He hurdles a man and goes out of bounds inside the 20.
Yeah, they need to find a way to account for that running back out of the backfield to become the fifth receiver in the route.
Burnett is scrambling here on defense. Able to get set though as Barrett Fallon patiently waiting for his blockers to develop. Number 75 pulling is the right guard, Anthony Rodriguez. Able to bust up Barrett Fallon for a gain of 5. Keeping it this time is Hamlin. Drops it off to Kyler Payne, and he bullies his way into the end zone, taking the umpire with him.
It's a really good job on an RPO read by the quarterback. They set up that because they ran the ball successfully 6 or 7 times before that, and then the safety just couldn't stand there. He had to come stop the run, and they found a receiver behind him.
It was the Barrett Fallon show until Kyler Payne wanted to get in on the party. A reception for Payne, a touchdown. His first of the game, 8 of the season. PAT up and good for Miles Mendez. And 4:21 left on the clock. We've got a good one here at Davenport. 24-21, the Wolves lead. You are watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
So, where are we eating?
With GVTC's blazing fast fiber speeds.
3.5 stars, not a chance we try anything under 4.
You might feel like other things in life are taking a little longer than before.
Ooh, what sounds better, La Fiesta or Dumpling Palace?
Ooh, Dumpling Palace.
Ew, gross.
We may not be able to speed up your dinner decisions, but we can provide fast and consistent premium Wi-Fi to search all the available options. Enjoy the GVTC difference, and please be patient with things that may have seemed to...
Wait, what are we gonna watch?
Slow down a bit. GVTC, connecting you.
Back-to-back touchdown drives, trying to catch Burnett off guard with a onside kick. Unsuccessful. Mendez is the kicker, but that one was kicked by number 3, Mason Falcone. Kind of one of those middle gunners. Decided to kick it and unable to bounce off the Bulldogs there. Good recovery and good field position.
I'm not sure that they were actually attempting to recover that. I think they just wanted to make it an off-schedule kick to somebody who doesn't normally field the ball, but the end result is good field position for Burnett.
He might have to be on the hands team pretty soon as well.
Yeah.
So good starting field position at the 47 for the Bulldogs. First down give going to the left side is number 20, Chris Kastner. That last drive for the Wolves went 45 yards and only took 1:27 off the play clock. Both offenses clicking on all cylinders, doing it two totally different ways. Slow and methodical versus fast and furious. 2nd and 7 for Burnett. Play action. Rolling is Murray, able to get it
good
away.
Pressure.
Murray was able to get out of the pocket, so they're not going to call intentional grounding. But good pressure there from Grant West. And it's going to be 3rd and long from the Burnett 49. They need the Davenport 43. What are you dialing up if you're Burnett right here?
Oh, they don't bring number 11 in, then it's just going to be one of their regular plays. I would say that little bubble screen fake and two receivers putting pressure on one safety.
Got twins to both sides. Here's that bubble screen tunnel. Trying to jump it was Davenport. It springs Gardner Krause for a big gain all the way inside the 35, marked down at the 33. It's one of those things, too. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Well, they haven't really stopped it yet. A couple of times in the first quarter they did, but after that,
just not consistently enough.
Yeah, it's just a running play, so be content with 5 yards. Be content with it might break.
Trips left to the short side. A give to Denton. Didn't get much. Another stop there in the middle. Slow to get up. Trying to work it out is C.J. Turner. one of the many seniors that got recognized on senior night. The first full class to go through Davenport High School. It's only the fourth year the school has been open. Second year the football team has played a UIL sanctioned season. Back to pass, Murray looking for it all and overthrows everyone. Was looking for Gardner Krause. The closest man was Cole Bourne, who's got two interceptions on the year for the Davenport defense. So they take a shot on second and long. Now it's third and nine. They need the 23, currently at the 32.
Seems like both teams have just lived in four down territory the whole game. Starts with great field position on their kickoff returns.
Trips right. We're going to fake a reverse, trying to go over the middle and undercutting it.
Safety just misplayed that. Mercy. He had it covered. He had it covered.
Touchdown, Burnett. Like you said, safety was in good position, decides to undercut it, and instead Murray's pass drops over.
It's not like he came forward and fell for that reverse fake or anything. He was in position to make the play. It's just the ball's in the air. Sometimes that's not as easy as it looks. Uh-oh.
And a bad snap on the PAT, fire drill, trying to get to the corner, and that's going to be a big point. Remember that play, because that makes it still a three-point game instead of a four-point game. So 2:04 left here from Davenport Stadium in the third quarter. Bulldogs respond to the Wolves' touchdown with a touchdown of their own. 27-24 is the score. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network. .204 left here in the third quarter. Back and forth we go between Burnett and Davenport. Short kickoff, trying to go to that wide side of the field and taken down. Number 20 of the Bulldogs with a big tackle. Chris Kasner, Anthony Moore was trying to reverse the field. Had a good return last time. Stopped there.
See if Burnett's defense can take advantage of reverse good field position. See if they can make Davenport do something that cost them.
Furthest back that Davenport has started for their opening field position. They'll start at their own 21. Give to Fallon. Bouncing it outside. Was very patient on that run.
Very disciplined, patient runner.
I mean,
must be nice to be that fast so you can just kind of slow down and turn it on when you want to.
He's got such quiet feet at the top of the run, and then once he sees where he wants to go, he goes full throttle. Second and four. He'll get the carry once again. He dives past the 30, and a late flag comes in.
Maybe lead with the helmet.
So we'll wait for the call. Like you said, late flag. Could have been a late hit. Lead with the helmet. We'll see what the call on the field is. Oh. So, personal foul on Burnett for a chop block.
Chop block on the defense is something I've never seen before.
Maybe going after one of the offensive linemen.
I haven't seen that penalty ever, I don't think, on a defensive play.
So that last drive for Burnett, 53 yards. The touchdown only took 2:17 off the clock. You got to be kicking yourself if you're Burnett head coach Brian Wood not taking 6 minutes off the clock. Hamlin rolling out to his left, looking for a receiver, and smartly just throws that one away. So second down.
It's a smart quarterback. I don't wonder how many times this season he's been sacked. He looks for the receivers and then gets rid of it. Doesn't do anything too risky back there, set up to pass.
He's completing his passes at 63% on the year. 2,300 yards, averaging 288 a game in the air, 24 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. Last week, 20 of 30, 363, 5 touchdowns against slam passes. Second and 10. They give it to Fallon. Again, quiet at the top of the run. Here gets that burst of speed over the 45-yard line of Burnett.
It's almost an option play. He waits a long time and sets up that blocker. The blocker has a chance to get around him, then he stays wide. The blocker has to knock that guy outside. He cuts back in.
Third and one. He gets the carry and is dropped in the backfield.
That's
coming
the
off the edge.
For loss.
And guess who? It's Trenton Park, who's been playing both sides of the ball. Caught the last touchdown. He's got over 100 receiving yards. And quite possibly the biggest tackle for loss puts Davenport at fourth down. The offense is going to stay on the field.
Watch him close to not try to draw him off sides.
Twins to each side. And a timeout right before the snap. Head coach J.D. Zimmerhansel is going to think things over. We'll take a break and get you ready for this fourth down play for Davenport. They're at the Burnett 47. They need the 38 when we come back. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolf Sports Network.
Wi-Fi!
Got the tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
I said I see it, and I like it, and I want it. Yes, I do. I need it to make me happy. Oh, baby, yes, I do mean you.
Fourth and four for Davenport. They're down by three with 18 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Sam Kamen alongside Brad Lynn. Let's put your coaching hat on right here. What are you drawing up if you're head coach JD?
They're not talking to the punt team, I can tell you that. They're going to run one of their best plays. I don't know why they don't give the ball to number 12 right here. He's a patient runner. They can set something up where it looks like pass. Doesn't have to be a draw play, but they don't have to throw it to get this with just a four yard necessary for first down.
Fallon's going to be to the left of Hamlin. Twins to each side. Three down linemen showing pressure is Burnett. They bring five, looking for help. Hamlin rolling out of the pocket, throw over the middle, caught by Fallon. Makes a man miss inside the 20, down at the 15. Who drew up jump ball to Barrett Fallon?
Yeah. Just made a tremendous play.
So Fallon, a big reception there.
That's the end of the third quarter, yeah.
And that will end the third quarter. To the fourth we go here at Davenport Stadium here on senior night. The Wolves have a chance to get a share of the district title and lock in the number one seed for District 13. We got a good one. Don't go anywhere here in San Antonio. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
Not the fun part of being a dad, but I have to speak to you about something that is concerning me.
Concerning you?
Yeah. heard you and your mother talking about this Arlo fella, and,
Arlo?
I wasn't eavesdropping. He's always watching you. His videos are secure. This guy sounds like a creep.
It's not.
Your privacy is very important to me, and I think you need to make better decisions when it comes to boys. And this Arlo is not a boy that I think you should be dating.
You're dating someone?
Yeah, Arlo. I heard you guys talking about him.
Arlo?
Yeah.
Dad, Arlo's the name of the new security cameras that we got from our service provider. We were talking about how great they are and how safe they make me feel. Arlo's not a boy.
Well, that's a boy's name.
Oh, boy.
Ah, not a boy. Apparently, we just learned that. It's a camera. Named after a boy. Why don't you name it Peter?
Start of the fourth quarter, Davenport down by three. They picked up a huge fourth and four on the throw and catch from Hamlin to Fallon. And they're going to give it back to Barrett Fallon, running over a man and finishing at about the 10-yard line. Over 80 yards on the ground, 59 yards through the air, or excuse me, on the receiving end. And none bigger than that last catch on fourth down. Second and medium. Going through the middle, and he's going to be just shy of the goal line. It'll be first and goal from the one for the Wolves. Quickly to the line. Fallon to Hamlin's left. A bobbled snap. Hamlin is able to get it and does not get back to the line of scrimmage. Tackled by number 51.
I don't need to do anything fancy. Hand it off to 12 three times. See what happens.
I didn't think that was a bad snap.
No, I think he was trying to read a safety. I think he had took his eyes off the ball while he was catching it.
So Fallon in the backfield alongside Griman. Griman to Hamlin's right. Fallon to the left. Two wide receivers to the top. RPO and... did they catch it? He did. I don't know how he fit it through that window. It was right over the top of the offensive lineman's helmet, and it found the hands of DeAnthony Moore.
That's the play he was trying to run when he bobbled it. Yeah. Good execution that time. So hard not to come tackle number 12 because he's had such great success, and then to find that receiver on a quick slant.
You play the pass in the RPO. They give it to Fallon. You play Fallon on the run option of the RPO. You find three possible receivers on this Wolves team. The kick was up and good. They're going to decline the penalty. So 10:47 left here in the fourth. Davenport back on top, 31-27. Over Burnett. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolves Sports Network.
Get a shake with your points and some fries on the side with your points.
You get more with every order. Woo!
Get a Whataburger or a patty melt or some breakfast with the points.
You get more with every order.
Get a biscuit or a brownie, but no matter what you pick, you get more. More.
Like your favorite Whataburger.
That last drive for Davenport, 80 yards, took 3:30 off their clock. The longest sustained drive for the Wolves ended in a touchdown by DeAnthony Moore and a huge fourth down conversion by Barrett Fallon, able to springboard Davenport back on top of Burnett. Every possession here in the second half has been a touchdown for either team. See who can get a stop down the stretch. Short kick.
Good field position again.
Burnett going to get it just shy of the 35. What about this Burnett offense has been clicking since just their third possession where they've put it in the end zone every single time?
That's pretty incredible when you say it like that, because the number of minutes they've milked off the clock doing it,
it makes you think that they haven't been as successful as they have been. We'll see if they don't worry a little bit and start going a little too fast because of the time of the game.
Averaging 31 points a game, just under 400 yards per game. A very balanced attack. Here's a busted, almost able to bust one loose, is Dash Denton right up the gut. A big tackle there for Davenport as Denton almost dashed all 67 yards there for a touchdown. Yards per game on the ground, 194 yards per game through the air. Brett Murray with Denton to the left. They're going to give it to Denton, and he busts up the middle once again. Back-to-back big-time runs for Dash Denton. And right back into Davenport territory are the Bulldogs. Both offenses have been able to dissect the defense. Both teams playing more of a 3-4, which you would think is playing more towards the pass.
Yes, it is. And so they're taking it. Both teams are taking advantage of being able to run the ball.
There's another give. This time, number 20, Chris Kastner.
Five straight running plays. Unique in this era of football. Fans start to get, why don't we throw? But they're making first downs, and they're using up that clock.
Uses up the clock. They're picking up 5-6 yards a carry. They're staying ahead of the chains. They've got trips to the far side of the field. Still only three down linemen, not showing any pressure as Davenport. Back to pass, looking for a deep shot. And that one is incomplete. He had it, and it was jarred loose.
I'd like to see that on the instant replay.
Number 11, C.J. Turner, with a big pass breakup there, has one on the season. And that one might have been a huge one here late in this fourth quarter. Gardner Krause had it in his hands, and Turner knocked it loose. So now it's a 3rd and 5, 8:41 on the clock. Denton running parallel. He's able to cut up field, and he has got a first down. Man, it looked like the Wolves were going to close on him, and he just got to the edge and able to get enough for the first down.
Some really good blocking on the perimeter out there by the wide receivers and that offensive tackle.
So another first down, keeps the clock moving. And actually,
I guess he was out of bounds on the tackle.
So it stops for the moment, 8:33. Under 10 on the play clock. Murray, quick pass, another screen. That one's to Krause, and able to gain a couple yards after the catch. And they continue to pick 4 or 5 yards on first down, whether it be on the run game or that bubble screen action extension of the run game. As long as they're staying ahead of the chains, they can milk as much clock as they want.
Really doing a good job of spreading the field, you know, attacking different places on the defense so that the defense can't just line up and know exactly where it's coming from.
Trips left. Kastner to the left of Murray. He gets the ball and
first down.
Waiting for the signal. It's right at the marker. Looks like a first down, but
guess not.
It's going to be third and short. Might be even less than a yard. Let's 7:30 left in the fourth. Two receivers to the left. Denton.
Uh-oh.
And he is in the end zone. Touchdown, Dash Denton.
Might have scored too soon.
Denton dashing his way all the way into the end zone on third and short. That's the third time he's kind of busted up the gut, and third time was the charm for him to find the end zone. And we've got an injury on the field.
You'd think sooner or later somebody would stop somebody, but that doesn't have to happen. It doesn't have to happen. Sometimes the clock just runs out while one offense is still doing its thing.
Both of these offenses are very, very good. 46 points per game for this Davenport offense. That's what we kind of expected, was them to put up the points. Over 500 yards per game, 300 through the air, over 200 on the ground.
The way the game started, too, with three plays and about 65 yards, then 40 seconds off the clock, you start doing the math, and, well, they're going to score 100. But
then those next two drives, you get Burnett that stalls out twice on fourth down. You get a punt, which is the only punt we've had of the game from Mendez,
right.
And then they fumble through the end zone that resulted in no points, and you're going, how is it only 7-0 after the first quarter?
Right, and you can only go fast when you're being successful. There's nothing worse than three quick incompletes that give the other team the ball.
And after that turnover, each team has scored a touchdown. Davenport really ran out of time there at the end of the first half. They had to settle for the field goal.
So that's the only non-touchdown drive since midway through the second quarter.
Very insane to think about. And it's a 34-31 lead for Burnett. Remember, a failed PAT just two possessions ago that could be looming large for this Bulldog team down the stretch. That last drive for the Bulldogs, going 67 yards, 325 taken off the clock, and the touchdown by the senior Dash Denton.
Really made a statement running the football, too. Not getting in a hurry, not nervous or panicked by the score late in the game like it is. They just went ahead and did what they're doing well.
Averaging 90 yards on the ground per game, had 84 last week, two touchdowns, and he was the main workhorse on that last drive. That injury on that last touchdown run was Zaire Livingston, so hopefully he's good to return, because he is a big piece of that Davenport defense. Here's Barrett Fallon with a big time return all the way down just shy of midfield. We haven't seen a lot of kickoffs go all the way back.
Probably not the guy you wanted to kick it to if you had your choice.
Emmett Grimans had a couple good returns, and I mean, you got to think that you don't want to hand the ball back to number 12, especially when you're kicking it, because Davenport's going to lean on him here in the remaining 7:08. Allen is to the left of Hamlin, able to bounce around and picks up two. Drive started at the 47. He gets to the 49-yard line of Davenport, so a pickup of two. Under 7 minutes left in this game. Davenport has already used one timeout. They've got two remaining. Burnett has all three. Second and eight. RPO. And just looking upfield just a bit too early was Emmett Griman.
That's really good execution by the quarterback. I know he'd like that ball to be a little easier for that kid to catch, but, man, they just throwing it where the safety can't be in two places at once.
It was right in the letters of that jersey, just trying to get upfield as he was at the 45 of Burnett. Was trying to get upfield for a first down instead. Incompletion. Third and eight. Back to pass, Hamlin looking over the middle. This one is jarred loose. A big hit there for Burnett. Number 35, Lou Laidler laid the wood there. And it's fourth down now for Davenport.
I'm not a smart man, but I would make sure I'd do something with number 12. They're going to get the ball to him.
So you got fourth and eight. You running a swing pass to Fallon?
Receiver out of the backfield has been very successful.
Tight set. Twins to both sides. Back to pass. Deep shot looking for a corner route, and that is incomplete. Hamlin looking for number 13, Dante Singletary. And there's the first stop
first
since
stop,
midway through
second
the
quarter.
Second quarter. And it comes midway through the fourth quarter. So
Burnett's having a party on their sideline, but they've got to execute and make some first downs right here. They don't need to give the ball back to Davenport.
That feels like they've won the game because you've stopped one of the most explosive offenses, just in the district, but the entire 4A. Yeah.
Still 6 minutes and 20 seconds, 19 seconds left on the clock.
Still a lot of work to do if you're Burnett.
See if Davenport does something besides a three down. No, they're still going to stop the pass by a lineman anyway.
Trips to the far side. Denton to Murray's left. They give to Denton. Minimal pickup there on first down. Second down. 71 yards for Dash Denton and a touchdown. ...17 carries for the senior. Play clock down to 10. Murray back to pass, quick throw. That one's caught and immediately dragged down by Colt Bourne. Colt Stanford with the catch. Over 100 yards now on the season. Only had 5 catches coming into this game. So here we are, approaching the 5-minute mark here in the fourth. Third and 4 from the 43. Need the 39 of Davenport. Trips left, running back to the right. Give, and the pile is
pretty
pushed
close.
All the way to the 39.
You know, I think they'll go for it on fourth down.
He's going to be a tad short. Line judge is going to spot the ball right on the 40. So it's going to be fourth down and a short yard. They brought in their H-back, Josiah Coronado. He's lined up right behind the right guard. Denton to Murray's left. And they're able to get a jump. They're going to take the free play, looking for Jones.
Ooh.
He caught it, but was out of bounds. And I don't know.
I don't think they called the jump ball.
I think they're saying that the jump was able to get back. And Coach Wood was very upset on that far sideline, thinking that should have been an offside penalty. We saw the jump. We thought we saw a flag go in the air.
It's pretty gutsy to try that on fourth down because it, you know, basically it's just a deep ball thrown on fourth down if you don't get that penalty.
And I think Rhett Murray thought that was a flag on the play, which would constitute why he went for the deep shot. And Fallon dropped for a loss.
Now both teams playing great defense.
Trenton Park with a tackle for loss. Funny how those things work. Momentum is a big and vital part.
Oh, yeah.
Hamlin giving out directions to Griman. Twins to both sides. Three-step drop. Going to check it down to Fallon. And he is pushed out of bounds at the 45. So that'll make it third and five. 3:39 left here in the fourth. They're going quick. They're staying. They're actually going to bring Griman into the backfield. To the right of Hamlin. Fallon to the left. Looking for a screen. Able to get the first down into Burnett territory. Had a lot of room to work with and able to pick up the first down. Trips right now, Fallon to the right of Hamlin. Zone read give to Fallon. He burst just shy of the 40 to the 41. Pickup of six. Clock now ticking towards 3 minutes left here in the fourth. A three-point lead for Burnett. Over 100 yards now is Barrett Fallon. Another give to him. Able to get to inside the 40. Still short of the sticks. Now it's third and three. Keep giving it to him?
Yes, I think they will.
Need the 37. Here's the give to Fallon. Again, patient behind his blockers.
Oh, man.
And the ball fumble. Comes out. And it's covered by Burnett. Trenton Park and Dash Denton right there to recover the fumble from Barrett Fallon. Two costly fumbles, one into the end zone by Griman. And Barrett Fallon looked like he was going to have the first down. Loses the ball, and with 2:19 left, Burnett can try to milk this clock out with a three-point lead, just really needing one first down.
Davenport can stop the clock one time, right?
They got two timeouts. Three timeouts for the Bulldogs. They've played three down linemen most of this game. See if they dial up the heat here. First down give. Nothing doing there. Right in the middle. And a timeout taken. So 2:11 left here in the fourth. No gain for Dash Denton. And what a game this has been. Beginning, it was a offensive spark by Davenport, then the defense for both teams getting a couple stops on fourth down, creating a couple turnovers. The offensive onslaught where neither team continued or couldn't get a stop from the middle of the second to the middle of the fourth, and then these last couple drives, the defenses have stood firm.
Yeah, both teams able to run the football during those back and forth drives where everybody was scoring, nobody stopping anybody. Both teams were successful running the football. You hate to see it come down to a turnover, but that might be the difference. We'll see. Wouldn't surprise me if Davenport doesn't get this ball back.
Two turnovers by the Wolves. Second down give. Going right side. Stood up at the line. Able to get forward for a couple more yards was Chris Kastner. And the third and final timeout taken by J.D. Zimmerhansel. So your second year head coach Brian Wood on the Burnett sideline. You're at your own 48. You need the 46 of Davenport. What are you dialing up here? Because you can run the ball and keep this clock going, or you can take a risk and put it.
Well, you haven't had to punt, or you've chosen not to punt, going for it on fourth down so many times successfully in the first half. One clock management thought is run the ball here. Should be zero timeout, so run the ball here and take the full time, and then on you know, on fourth down, well, no, it's the clock has stopped, so you're only going to run about 40 seconds off.
You run
maybe
the
take
ball.
The penalty. Maybe take the penalty and run the clock down, even though it's fourth down.
If it's fourth and short, you think you're going for it?
Fourth and short, I would go for it. Yep, I would.
So they got trips to the left. That's the wide side of the field. Murray, excuse me, it's Grant Jones, and he busts through down the sideline. It's going to be a foot race. Nobody's going to catch him. They go with the Wildcat. Grant Jones has only gotten 26 rushes on the year.
That was his best one, though.
231 yards, had a touchdown last week on the ground, and he finds the end zone once again.
Well, so much for my unmathematical analysis of clock management. They didn't need it.
But now Davenport's got a chance to go back and answer. Would have to get the onside kick as well. PAT is up and good. So 1:56 left here.
Wow, that's huge. That's really big.
Davenport down by 10 with 1:56 left. Can they have a magical comeback here at home on senior night? Come back and find out. You're watching Texas High School Football on the Wolf Sports Network.
Hold on to your horses, because it's back. Unless you didn't know about it, in which case, it's here. The Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit is back and here for a limited time at Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Yard touchdown on third down. Instead of going to Dash Denton or Chris Kashner, Brian Wood goes to Grant Jones, the senior wide receiver in the Wildcat formation, to put him up two scores, burning up 41-31, but not out of the woods yet. A very explosive Davenport offense can put up points in a hurry. Making a move up to the 30 on the return. So they'll have a minute 50 to score a touchdown, get the onside kick, and possibly kick a field goal to tie this one and push it to overtime. In under 2 minutes, the sideline and the chains are your fans.
Really deep.
Here's that 4-2-5 look that we've seen. Haven't seen it much across the middle, and miscommunication there between Soakup and Hamlin. So an incomplete pass. Only wasted three seconds off the clock. Trips right.
Rushing three, playing pass with everybody else.
We're going to roll to the right of Hamlin. And Payne, right near the sideline, makes the catch, gets out of bounds. 1:41 left on the clock. Picks up 8. So third and 2 now for the Wolves. You can run the ball here if you're Davenport. Clock will stop on a first down until they can reset the chains. Looking for a quick out as Hamlin, able to direct traffic to Kyler Payne. He steps out once again. 1:34 left on the clock. This is a offense that can get down the field. They've got the awareness and veteran leadership to know what needs to get done here down the stretch. Bunch trips to the left side. Looking for a deep shot down the sideline. Jump ball and incomplete. Hamlin looking for Soak Up. Defended there by number 15, Jacob Atkinson. So second and 10 from the Burnett 46. 127, two wide receivers to the top, plus Griman as the tight end. Rolling out to the left is Hamlin. He finds Soak Up. He's got a first down, steps out right at the 30. Again, 119, not a lot of time getting taken off that clock. Everything's been an incompletion or out of bounds, which have really helped conserve that time. And Coach Wood's going to take a timeout here, trying to get a breather for their defense. They need it.
Content to let the quarterback have all the time in the world and find those receivers. I'm a big fan of pass rush because these kids practice throwing and catching without pads on all summer long. So you've got to do something to upset his rhythm or his footwork or something. He's completing every pass now.
Well, it seems like they're playing a lot of zone right now. When they've been in man coverage, they've done a pretty decent job of locking up the Davenport wide receivers. They haven't had much cushion.
Well, and even in great coverage, they've made some great catches anyway, so you might as well rush the passer because they're going to catch it anyhow if you give him time to throw.
So again, 119 left. Davenport down by 10. Hamlin has thrown for 253. Three touchdowns. Trying to look for a comeback here on senior night. Only undefeated team in the district. Last year, 10-2. Their only district loss to Canyon Lake. Their second year of UIL 4A football. Trying to win their first district championship. Can do so with a win. Being heated up is Hamlin and able to flick it towards Soak Up. Avoids.
Stop the clock and avoids a sack.
That's a huge play there by Tristan Hamlin. Great pursuit from that backside by Riley Howell, sophomore defensive end. 15 pressures on the season. None bigger than that one. Almost creating a sack. So 114. Second and 10 from the 29. Twins to both sides. They're going to motion Soak Up to the wide side of the field. Fake a quick bubble screen to Fallon. It's Kyler Payne that goes nowhere. Shot stopped right at the line to gain. Now the clock will run. Now under a minute. Working quick. Third and 10. Hamlin looking for the out route with
Payne. Don't let
Payne.
Him out of bounds. He got out.
So short of the sticks, it'll be fourth down, but it stops the clock. At the 25 now, the Wolves need the 19. 46 seconds left. This could be the game. Hamlin giving out directions. Griman line up as the tight end. Two receivers to the top. Here comes some heat. Rush four over the middle. Soak Up breaks a tackle inside the five, down at the four. Clock will stop at 38 seconds as they get the chain set up. Hamlin calling out the play. Clock is running. 35-34. Two backs in the backfield. Fallon. It's going to be an RPO looking for Griman, and that one's deflected by Burnett. Trenton Park continues to be stellar on both ends. Over.
I think he got hurt batting that ball down. Might be a hurt. There's no telling.
And that's Lou Laidler.
That's the kid who made the play, yeah.
Lou Laidler was the guy that was in pursuit of Hamlin. Looks like it might just be possibly cramps as he's up. He's getting stretched out and now is getting carried off.
Yeah, he won't move that cramping leg, I guess. Yeah.
Dragging him off the field.
Trying to get him back on. They're trying to get him back on for another play.
It's like the Charlie horse. When it just tightens up, you don't want to move, but
it's easy to say he should get up. He's not really injured until you've had one. Then you know it's not that easy. It can be very paralyzing.
And they've been going nonstop here this final drive. 27 seconds remain. Inside the five, rolling to his left is Hamlin, trying to get it back to Grime, and he was open, just overthrew him. Good play call there by Davenport, just could not find his target. He hasn't had many overthrows or many incompletions. That one was probably a walk-in touchdown for Emmett Griman. So third down. Ball is at the four. Two receivers to the wide side. Griman at the tight end position. Out of the backfield is Fallon. That one's behind Barrett Fallon. And now...
That's rare. Two throws in a row that the quarterback was just off by a little.
So now it's fourth down. And coach is going to send
kick
out the field goal unit.
I guess. Kick the field goal now and go onside kick.
I mean, you need both, so it makes sense.
Yeah.
He's already made a 32-yarder today. This will be a 21-yarder. And that one is up and good. So 14 seconds left in this ball game. The field goal cuts it to a one-possession game. 41-34, and now we will see if they can get the onside kick. Biggest play of the ball game.
Will be the biggest play, that's right.
And they had what almost looked like a onside kick earlier with Mason Falcone kind of kicking it instead of Miles Mendez. How do you draw up a onside kick? It's not very successful, but there's got to be a recipe for success.
Well, you have to be aware that if the ball doesn't come to you, you need to go block somebody. If the ball's not in your hands, then you need to be blocking somebody. It's one of those plays that they may outlaw it one day because it can be dangerous. There's usually no penalties called on this play other than offside.
So 56 yards go the Wolves. They take 1:32 off the clock and cash in with a 21-yard field goal. Onside kick, Mendez got the hop. There's a big hit from Griman trying to jar it loose. It was legal, but it was number one. Dash Denton. And Burnett is going to get out of Davenport with a big upset win and send the seniors on senior night going away not happy.
Should be able just to take a knee and not stop the clock. Yeah.
11 seconds. As long as the snap is handled good, you know.
Kicker executed that kick really well. It did the two hops, and then it goes high, and the Davenport kids almost got there at the right time.
It was a short hop that even because it hit right before Denton and then it popped straight up. Go shotgun victory formation and the Burnett Bulldogs able to get out of Davenport with an upset victory. They move to 6-3 on the year, 3-1 in district play. Davenport will move to 6-3 on the year, also 3-1 in District 13 play. And that's kind of Texas high school football. It's going to come down to the last week of the regular season next week
to see who's the district champion. That's correct.
And that has
huge playoff implications. So there won't be anybody resting any starters or worrying about that. They need to win that game. Both of these teams need to win next week. So they of course Davenport's not excited at all about losing this game late in the season like that, but they've got to get ready because they have a chance with their offensive power to go a while in the playoffs.
And it could be coming down to a big tiebreaker because Lampasas is 6-2 coming into today, 2-1, and depending on how their game today went against Marble Falls, all three teams could be 3-1 going into next week. As we look at the schedule for next week, the Wolves will be at Marble Falls, a 7:30 kickoff there, as well as the Burnett Bulldogs. They will be playing Taylor at home in their senior night at 7:30, which means Lampasas.
What a great show of sportsmanship out here in midfield.
Yep. And then the other game, Lampasas, will be at Canyon Lake next weekend. So a hard-fought game by both the Burnett Bulldogs and the Davenport Wolves. Just goes the Bulldogs' way here today. Great show of sportsmanship, like you said, here on senior night. 26 seniors on the football team recognized, and they still have a shot at that district title in year number 4. Of the program, second year of UIL season. And just exactly how you draw it up, if you're the Burnett Bulldogs,
if you were flipping channels and looking for something cool and you found it, you got lucky. Or if you were just driving by and you saw these lights on, you showed up, wondered what was going on, what a great night. Really good job.
Try to get our final stats of the game. Again, Burnett, their defense has been what's carried them, only giving up 20 points per game, giving up under 300 yards per game. But the biggest number, plus 6 turnover margin, they were plus 2 today with two big ones.
That was the turning point in the first half to make Burnett think that they had a chance to stay in this game. Of course, in the second half, that was just a game changer because no one was stopping Davenport at that time other than the turnover.
And outside of the fourth down stops, if you count those as turnovers, Davenport got a couple, but those two fumbles proved to be just a bit too costly. And our final numbers for Davenport, 21 of 38, 253, and 3 touchdowns. For Tristan Hamlin, a good game from him. Barrett Fallon had 2 touchdowns, over 100 yards. Again, his 7th 100-yard rushing game for Burnett. Rhett Murray continues to be a stable quarterback. 17 touchdowns on the year, had 3 touchdowns, 16 of 18 last week for 361 today, 24 of 32, 274, and 2 touchdowns. As they were able to spread the rock around all the way. Big thanks to everyone on our crew, our cameraman Nick, Ben, and Jason, Tony on stats, our director Carl, and my play-by-play and color analyst Brad Lynn. So this has been a Wick Productions presentation of Davenport High School football, our final from Davenport Stadium, the Burnett Bulldogs 41, the Davenport Wolves 34. We will see you come playoff time here on the Texas High School Wolves Sports Network. Everyone, have a good one.